Just about ready for baseball on MLB Network as you get a look at beautiful Yankee Stadium in Bronx, New York. Today, game three of this four-game series between the Cleveland Indians and the New York Yankees. Major League Baseball on MLB Network is next. Corey Kluber, a right-hander from Alabama, gets the starting assignment. What's your take on him, Dan?
Their ball club is going to have to keep a close eye on this one. This guy's nearing 200 innings on the season, and that's a lot of innings. A guy that takes the ball every 5 days. I'm sure they're going to watch to see if there are any signs of him tiring early in this one.
So now into the box is Jose Ramirez, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Now a cutter down around his shoe tops as he hops out of the way. 65 degrees our temperature here at first pitch. And this is swung on and missed on a great pitch that time, and the leadoff man is down on strikes to get this one started.
This is the pitch I think we'll see a lot from him in this game. The cutter darting in on the hitters in the opposite batter's box. It can be a real effective pitch when it's located well, and that one was right there.
Hard hit ball to second. LeMahieu's got it, and that's the second out.
Batting third.
Now a moment here for the Indians starting lineup. Mark DeRosa, what you got in this lineup as they try to clinch a division title?
Are we still a big believer in batting average, Matty? In today's game, I'm more interested in the OPS number. But that's not to take anything away from this offense. They lead the league in batting average, and what that tells me is they're getting a lot of guys on base. There's a lot of guys with some good approaches and good plans today. See if that leads to a bunch of runs.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Indian shortstop behind one and two in the count.
The offensive game plan today is certainly to see the ball up. This guy is known on the mound for sinker changeup combination.
And meanwhile now, here's a drive out to right center. And this ball is going to clear the wall. It's a home run. Solo shot to right center. Home run number 51 on the year as the Tribe move out in front 1-0.
Love the homer in the top of the first inning. Give your pitcher a chance to kind of regroup and gather himself with an early lead.
Into the box, Franmil Reyes. A bouncer to the left side. Iglesias is there. Throw on to Voit takes care of him, and the inning is over. Indian strike for one on this solo homer. On to the bottom of the first now from Yankee Stadium, and the Tribe are off to an early 1-0 lead. Cal Quantrill is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for Cleveland. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a look at a guy that's really dependable. Last three starts, ERA just under 3.00, and that's some pretty good pitching. Minimizes the amount of walks, keeps his hits down, and if he can do more of the same of that, he should have some pretty good fortune in this one here today.
Here's the shortstop now, Jose Iglesias. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. He pops him up toward the left side of the infield, and this is taken in for out number one.
Batting second, the third baseman.
With that, it's time to check out the starting lineup for the hometown Yankees. Mark, daytime baseball at home, what do we need to know about these guys?
You know, Matty, when I look at this lineup at first glance, the fact that they're last in doubles doesn't mean a whole lot to me. But then you got to say to yourself, if they're not driving the ball in the gap, they're certainly not driving it out of the ballpark. So this offense has to clean it up, play a little bit differently, be a little bit more aggressive on the base pass, because you can't expect them to string a ton of hits together.
Now the 2-1 pitch. 2-2 the count. Into the windup and the pitch. High in the air out to center field. Phillips is there, two gone.
Batting third, the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
And now in the box, DJ LeMahieu. His prior history versus this arm, he's just 1-for-6. The 1-1 home. Line down the left field line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff.
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Eddie Rosario. Grounded back up the middle. Iglesias is up with it. Throw is in time for the first out of the second.
Batting six.
All right, boys, let's take a look at how the Yankees are setting up on defense today. And let's focus on Giancarlo Stanton right now. Looks like he's chiseled out of stone out there. The outfielder, I know he has light tower power, but he's also helpful on the defensive side and possesses a strong arm in the outfield.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Josh Bell. One of the better hitters in the league this year, currently 7th in the American League in hitting.
There's no way you could have forecasted this kind of season from this guy. Not to take anything away from him, but I don't think many people in baseball considered him to be one of the league's best hitters for average coming into this year.
Lifted down the line and left, and that will end up a foul ball. One out, nobody on. A bouncer up the middle, and that'll get on through into center, and he's got himself a one-out hit. Well, when you're going as well as he is, not even a two-strike count is going to get in your way.
Yeah, Matty, he's having a monster season, well over 300. Right there, when you're feeling that confident at the plate, it doesn't matter what the count is. You're willing to go deep and still feel confident.
At the plate now, Brett Phillips. Now a chopper to second. This will be a tough turn. Throw gets him, two down.
Batting eight.
Next, it'll be Jason Dominguez. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. The 1-1. Took him right up the ladder that time, and it's 1-2.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
The 1-2 is a breaking ball that can't find the zone, and it's even at 2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Over to first, and that retires the side. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. On now to the bottom of the second. The Indians lead it 1-0. Striding in is Aaron Judge. And there you see the numbers over his last 8 contests. He's really been leading the charge for this team. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Fastball was too much for him there. Swung right through it. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Here it comes. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
1-1. This is on the ground over to first.
Bell brings it in.
Throw gets him. Two down.
Good pitch right there to run the two-seamer in on his hands and bunch him up. And an easy ground ball as a result.
Into the box now. Gleyber Torres. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll hit off the wall in left center. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
That's what happens when a slider doesn't do what you want it to do. That was just one of those cement mixers, kind of just spinning but doing nothing. Nice job.
We'll have to leave it there as the play is made for the third out. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this.
Welcome back to the Bronx, where these fans have witnessed a lot of good pitching from their Yankees this season. Entering the day, they rank in the upper echelon of several pitching categories, and that doesn't go unnoticed around the clubhouse. One of the position players told me, "Our pitching staff has a calming influence on the entire team. We know they're going to keep us in games, and flat out, they just get the job done, and that helps everyone play more relaxed and confident. It appears this group of pitchers is a real cornerstone of this ball club, guys."
All right, thanks, Heidi. The 1-1. Waves and misses for strike number two. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Now here's the pitch. And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
There's ball four.
And with the bases empty and three balls, I think they were probably just saying, hey, we're not going to compound our mistakes here. Better issue a free pass and give him something to drive.
Lifted into center field. Kiermaier giving chase. He makes the running play. Two down.
The batter, number eight.
Stepping up is Patrick Connolly, and we'll see what he can do here after going deep his first time up.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
Here's a bouncing ball headed to LeMahieu at second. Throw to first beats him easily, and the side is retired. One left for the Tribe, but they're on top 1-0. Bottom of the inning now, and up to bat next, it'll be the catcher Kyle Higashioka. And this one's high and tight, backing him up 2-1.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout, this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Dominguez is there, one away.
Batting
coming.
Well, it's still early, but it's also worth noting that he'd be in line for the win if this keeps up as we take a look at the league leaders in games won this season. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. One out here in the Yankees' third inning, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. Now the 1-1 pitch. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. And another foul ball. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
The 2-2 one more time. Swinging a ball hit in the air to right field, and deep back is the right fielder, but he will look up and watch this one sail out of here. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Home run number 9 on the year, and the Yankees have drawn even now at 1 apiece.
I know hindsight's 20-20, but you can't throw that pitch to that guy. Don't forget, he homered yesterday, so you know he's locked in and ready to roll up there. We'll see if he learns from that mistake.
In now, Jose Iglesias. Softly hit toward the hole. He's got it. And there's out number 2.
Not a lot you can do with that pitch. That fastball just ate him up inside and gets the soft grounder for the out.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating.
Looking at a fastball to end the inning. But a run scores in the inning, and that'll have to be good enough as this solo home run knots things up. We're through 3 in the Bronx, all even at 1 apiece. So now it'll be the 4-hole hitter, Franmil Reyes. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Now the 3-2 pitch. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Judge looks up. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Number 36 on the year for him. And the Tribe take a 2-1 lead.
Yeah, it's a long season with a lot of peaks and valleys, but he's getting hot here in September. That bodes well for him and his team as things crank up in October. We'll see if he can stay hot when it matters the most.
Stepping in now, Eddie Rosario. Good job there on 1-2 as he winds up getting the bunt down. And he'll beat the throw as he's got himself a bunt single.
You know, D-Roll, that's not a bad way to keep it going. A base hit right there, hitting streak, 15 games and counting.
Yeah, we're halfway through a calendar month, and he looks up and he's had a knock. You can't get caught up in it. You have to trust the process. Keep doing what got you to this point.
Meanwhile here, this is going to be trouble out there in left center as it ought to be good for extra bases. And the runner from first comes around to score. So now time will be called as we're going to get a visit from the pitching coach here as he'll hope to settle this guy down. At the plate, Brett Phillips. And he'll take strike three called, and he needed that one badly on the mound. One away. Digging in next, Jason Dominguez comes into this at-bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Bell, the runner at second with one away. This is flared out towards second. In time to first, and there are two away.
The catcher, number 17, Austin Hedges.
So next to bat will be Austin Hedges, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7, 8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Another one sent foul. Three runs, five hits, no errors to this point for the Indians. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Judge is under it. And that's the third out. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. It's the Indians 3 and the Yankees 1. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up DJ LeMahieu.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
The 1-2. Bat explodes as this has popped up. And that's out number one.
Now batting, right fielder, Aaron
Judge. And that'll bring up Aaron Judge. Now the 1-1 pitch. Three to one is our score here in inning number four. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. And a base hit into left field, so they've got themselves a one-out base runner.
Hey, D-Row, are you aware of this? After that knock right there, that's an 11-game hitting streak. You think he knows it's at 11?
I think he knows exactly that it's at 11. It starts off innocent. You just want to get a few knocks to get the hitting coach off your back. Next thing you know...
Well, the play's been made, and with it comes the end of the inning. Yanks held in check. Score holds. It's 3-1. Striding in for the Indians, Jose Ramirez, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
Yeah, this is his power side, Matt. He definitely quite a bit more pop in his bat swinging left-handed.
Swung on and chopped up the middle, reined in. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
The batter number 7, second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
Ready now is Cesar Hernandez. Two balls and a strike to Cesar Hernandez. The 2-1. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. On the move is Stanton. He gets there, and that's the second out.
Now batting, shortstop, Patrick Connolly.
Next to hit is Patrick Connolly. He bounced out last time up. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Inside as he nearly got him, and it's ball four. And that'll bring in Franmil Reyes. It was a solo shot for him in his last at-bat.
Yeah, Matt, that last at-bat, that was a pretty good pitch. A fastball down and away that he went out and hooked and pulled it. So if I'm on the mound right now, I'm going to have to think about throwing one up and in and standing this guy up to make that outside corner not as appealing.
Runners on the move for second. Pitch inside. The throw way late, and he's in there easily at second.
Good steal there, and I'll tell you, he is a multi-dimensional player out there. He's got good pop at the plate, and he showed he's not afraid to use his wheels on the bases either.
To your point, Dan, he did go deep earlier, and now the stolen base here, so he's really having an impact on this game. The 2-1 on its way. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
The 3-1. A shot down the first baseline. And the stolen base winds up as a moot point as the inning is over. Indians leave one as the lead remains 3-1. Welcome back to the Bronx as we check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with the Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Thank you, Heidi. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And there's the first out. So this has been another fine outing for him this afternoon as we check out the league leaders in ERA. And as you can see, he's up near the top, currently sixth in the AL in that category. And now here is Giancarlo Stanton. 1 run on 3 hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. And it's fouled away. Another 1-2 delivery. Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone.
Now batting.
So the next to bat will be Kyle Higashioka. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. 1-2 to the Yankees catcher.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter-friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
3-1 our score as we play inning number 5. Liner towards second. Throw on to Bell at first, and the side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. They still trail it here 3-1. Top half of the sixth about to get started. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Eddie Rosario. Ready with the 1-1 pitch.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Set to deliver on 2-1. Swing, and there it goes. He got all of that ball. And gone. An absolute bomb. Solo shot to right center. Home run number 42 on the season. And the Tribe have opened it up to 4-1.
Man, this has been a rough one for this guy so far. That's the third homer he's allowed today. He better start keeping the ball down in the strike zone, or that total might continue to rise.
Here comes the Yankee skipper on his way to the mound, and a change is in the offing, as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. Just five innings of work for him here, as he really never found his rhythm in this one. Casey Mize takes over on the mound here with nobody out in the sixth inning.
Number 12, Casey Mize.
Into the box, Josh Bell. Ripped down the line. And this will stay inside the third base bag. A fair ball. Throw into second. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
As we look again at that double here, you can see that he was thinking too right out of the box. Smashed it down the line, and that was some great hustle to beat the throw to second to earn himself a double.
Standing in now, Brett Phillips. And it's a 2-2 count to Brett Phillips. And this is swung on and missed. And boy, they took care of a key man there. One away. Stepping in once again is Jason Dominguez, grounded out in his last at bat. Now the 2-1. Austin Hedges is on deck. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Three-two pitch. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. And he's going to score with ease, as the throw will be too late.
Dan, how hard is it to massage your way through such a deep lineup? I mean, even the 8-9 hole hitters are solid big league players.
You know, Mark, these days you're not seeing a lot of defensive specialists in the infield or outfield. If you're in that starting lineup these days, there's a pretty good job you can swing the bat.
At the plate now, Austin Hedges. Pitch outside, the throw. Tagged by LeMahieu, and they got him at second base.
Wow, that's a big-time throw right there, and it's a tall task to throw him out stealing a bag, but he got rid of it quickly, and it was a good job down there applying the quick tag. They'll have to feel good about that one.
Struck him out, so he set down on strikes for the second time today. So it's two runs on three hits, including the home run. No errors and no one left. On to the bottom of inning number six. Cleveland's out in front, 5-1. Kevin Kiermaier will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. 1-1. Is taken for ball two. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Now another 2-2. Popped him up. Hedges waits on it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
The batter number 13, shortstop, Jose Iglesias.
Now into the box, Jose Iglesias. We're in the sixth inning now of a 5-1 ball game. Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees leadoff man. High in the air out to center field. Phillips is there now, and he has it, two gone.
Now batting, number 29.
That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. Two out, nobody on. Fouled away. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Hit back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. They're down here 5-1. Here's a bouncing ball headed to LeMahieu at second. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7.
Now batting, the second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
Next, it'll be Cesar Hernandez, flew out last time up. Seventh inning here in a 5-1 ball game. Grounded back up the middle and into center field as he's aboard with a one-out single.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped a base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
Patrick Connolly will stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. And here you go, a solo home run that had him off and running early on. He's set. Here's the 3-2. A bouncer to the left side, and that gets through for a one-out base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single.
Hey, you know it's not a hit and run right there with a 3-2 full count. Just putting a runner in motion, but it worked out just the same. Nice base hit right there, and we got first and third.
Aaron Slagers come on now and make his 55th appearance of the year.
Number 58, Aaron Slagers.
Into the box now, Franmil Reyes. Hit out towards second. Dive, but it's in and out of the glove, and the run should score. Throw to first, not in time, as the run is across to score.
The left fielder, number 9, Eddie Rosario.
Eddie Rosario will stride in one more time as we flash you back to earlier. This was a big blow right here as he leaves the yard with plenty to spare. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
Now, you don't have to be a genius to figure out what the plan of attack is. It is ambush city on this guy. Two hits on back-to-back pitches, and this guy comes unglued.
Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
The first baseman, number 23.
Now at the plate, Josh Bell. He hit a two-bagger and later scored in his previous plate appearance.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
Squares with two outs and gets it down. Throw over to LeMahieu at second, and that'll do it. So it's a run on three hits, no errors, and two men left on. Seventh inning stretch time now here in the Bronx. It's the Indians 6 and the Yankees 1. Last half of the seventh here, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu. Now time is called as both guys in the bullpen are ready to go. Here comes the Indians manager to make that slow trip to the mound. And he's going to motion for the bullpen, as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. Tired a bit as he reached the seventh, but he's got a shot at the victory if his bullpen can help him out. Nick Wittgren comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number 7.
Number 62, Nick Wittgren.
Ball and two strikes, here it is. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone. Next up, Aaron Judge. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch. It swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
So he chased out of the strike zone on that one. Aaron Judge becomes out number 2 this inning. Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Now here's one high and deep to left. If it stays fair, it's gone. And it's a foul ball.
Ah, man, just a hair early on that one and just pulled it foul. He's going to have to find a way to refocus. Not easy to continue an AB after you just went deep foul.
He'll get it into second, and he'll coast into second here with a two-out double. Well, it took him till the seventh, but he gets his first hit of the game here, and that'll extend his hitting streak.
Yeah,
we'll have to press pause as that's strike three to retire the side. One left for the Yankees. They trail 6-1. Start of the eighth on its way, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with this report.
Matt, I talked with manager Terry Francona during the break about his thoughts on the Indians' hitters to this point. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Looking at the numbers, they currently have 4 hits coming from at-bats where they were behind in the count. That indicates that these guys are absolutely battling at the plate and making it very difficult for the opposition to get them out.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Ready to begin the eighth, and that brings up outfielder Brett Phillips. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Kiermaier on the run. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
Now batting, right fielder.
Next to hit, Jason Dominguez. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Grounded to third. And quickly, there are 2 away.
Up next to Cleveland, the catcher, Austin Hedges.
Digging in will be Austin Hedges. And he hasn't quite had the same fortune at the plate as many of his teammates. No hits for him so far. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Judge is under it. And the inning is over. Indians go down 1-2-3. They hold on to their 6-1 lead. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. And next it'll be the outfielder, Giancarlo Stanton. Fouled off. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
Here's the 1-2. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Here comes the 1-2. Gets him looking up around the letters. So a pitching clinic there as he sets him down in order, all via the punch out. More from MLB Network Saturday Baseball after this. Luis Sessa enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Jose Ramirez. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Running hard. He's digging for second. And he is into second base with a leadoff double. So he waited till the ninth inning, but he comes through here to extend the hit streak. That was close.
Yeah, Matty V, you see that wry smile of him coming out of the box right there? He knew what was on the line. He'd be lying if he didn't.
There's a lot of pressure on you because you're walking into that batter's box thinking, I have a nice streak going, and this is more than likely going to be my last AB. He comes through in the clutch.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Stanton comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out.
Now batting, the shortstop, Patrick Connelly.
Now to bat, Patrick Connelly. He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point. The 3-1 lifted down the line in left, and this will wind up a foul ball. Ready with the payoff pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. He gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third. Next for the Indians is the designated hitter, Fran Moraes. Past meetings against Luis Sessa, just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. The 2-1. Swing and a line drive. In there, base hit, and that ought to get the run in from third.
I mean, that had to feel good right there, Dan. That's his third RBI of the game and extends his team's lead. They might have this one locked up.
Well, I tell you, those are always big, those add-on insurance runs. Big RBI right there for a little bit more breathing room.
And there's strike three. So we'll see now if they can manage to hold on to this huge lead as the side is retired. Two hits in the inning lead to a run for Cleveland. To the bottom of the ninth we go. Top of the order due up. The Tribe lead this one 7-1. Emmanuel Clase is on, and he'll take now over on the mound in relief.
Number 48, Emmanuel Clase.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Jose Iglesias. Now the 1-1 pitch. Taken, strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Skied into straightaway right. Dominguez is there, and that's not the start to the bottom of the ninth this crowd was hoping for. One away.
Now batting, number 29.
Next for New York, Gio Urshela. The 3-2 pitch, and he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four. And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in this at bat.
So it was a strikeout looking there. DJ LeMahieu becomes out number two in the bottom of the ninth. Last chance for the Yankees. Into the corner and slicing foul. Urshela, the runner at first with two gone. And the Indians are off to the postseason, champions of the AL Central.
Hey, it's hard to win games at any point, but to win games on the road, especially in this ballpark, so they are very happy with this win.
7-1 the final today. The Cleveland Indians, with their 97th win, tops in the division. Cal Quantrill gets his 18th win of the year, the best on the staff. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.